What's up, party people? It's Keys Dan with RadioWhat.com, DJLittleRock.com, coming to you live in a Lemmy Color from the Radio What Studios. And this is my podcast, What Makes You Smarter? It's an extension of the RadioWhat.com internet radio station that I've been running for quite some time. And if you need DJ services, where do you go? DJLittleRock.com. Check availability and get a free price quote. And maybe you can have me at your next events. If you'd like to tell your story, I encourage you to check out my other podcast, What Makes You Famous. Find it everywhere using the hashtag What Makes You Famous. But for today, let's learn some things on What Makes You Smarter. Now, on with the show. Today on the program, 10 things you need to know today for Monday, June 1st, 2020. 10 things you need to know today. Number one, protests continue for a sixth day since George Floyd's death in police custody. Protests continued Sunday for a sixth night over the death of an unarmed black man, George Floyd, in Minneapolis police custody. There were mostly peaceful demonstrations during the day with outbreaks of looting in some cities. Thousands were arrested. Curfews have been enacted in more than two dozen cities, and the National Guard has been activated in 15 states and Washington, D.C., where riot police pushed back thousands of protesters after a fire was set across from the White House. Chicago Mayor Lori Lightfoot, Democrat, restricted access to her city's downtown area, making it accessible only to residents and essential workers. Atlanta authorities fired two police officers and placed three others on desk duty for using excessive force during a Saturday protest. This is according to the Washington Post and the Associated Press. Number two, officials warn demonstrations could result in coronavirus spike. Public officials across the country on Sunday warned that mass protest over police violence against African Americans could result in a spike in coronavirus infections. The protests in at least 75 cities have brought large crowds together, often shoulder to shoulder. Maryland Governor Larry Hogan, Republican, warned that, quote, thousands of people jammed in together in close proximity, end quote, could easily spread the virus. Atlanta Mayor Keisha Lance Bottoms, Democrat, expressed the same concern. Quote, I'm extremely concerned. We are seeing mass gatherings, end quote, she told CNN. Quote, we're going to see the other side of this in a couple of weeks, end quote. As states gradually reopen their severely damaged economies, the number of infections nationwide has risen to nearly 1.8 million, with more than 104,000 deaths. This is according to the New York Times and CNN. Number three. Trump vows to label anti-fascist activists as terrorists. President Trump on Sunday blamed radical leftists for outburst of violence as protests against police brutality spread across the country. Trump tweeted that his administration, quote, will be designating Antifa as a terrorist organization, end quote, using the shorthand name used to refer to a loose movement of, quote, anti-fascist, end quote, activists. Attorney General William Barr said that violence by, quote, Antifa and similar groups, end quote, is, quote, domestic terrorism and will be treated accordingly, end quote. Legal experts said that Antifa is not an organization with a structure Trump could penalize. They also noted that there is no domestic terrorism law, so Trump would not have the authority to follow through on his statement. Some observers said the administration was merely trying to divert attention from the broad anger over killings of African Americans by police that sparked the protests. This is according to the New York Times and the Washington Post. Number four, report, Trump moved to White House bunker during Friday's protests. On Friday night, President Trump spent nearly an hour in an underground bunker as protesters gathered outside the White House, CNN and the New York Times reported Sunday. The Secret Service put up metal barriers to keep the protesters at bay, and some threw objects like water bottles at the officers. At one point, after demonstrators pushed against them, agents used pepper spray. The Secret Service decided to move Trump underground as the tension escalated, CNN reports. It is unclear if he was joined by First Lady Melania Trump and their teenage son, Barron Trump. Trump tweeted on Saturday that the Secret Service did, quote, a great job last night at the White House, end quote, as they were, quote, not only totally professional, but very cool, end quote. This is according to CNN and the New York Times. Number five, astronauts dock and enter space station. NASA astronauts Bob Behnken and Doug Hurley arrived at the International Space Station on Sunday in SpaceX's Crew Dragon, the first spacecraft to carry humans into space from U.S. soil since 2011. The docking came 19 hours after launch from Kennedy Space Center in Florida. The launch was originally scheduled for Wednesday, but lightning and rain led to its postponement. Weather threatened to derail Saturday's launch as well, but the skies cleared in time. The mission, a joint effort by NASA and SpaceX, marked the first time a private company sent a spacecraft carrying a crew into space. After docking, Behnken and Hurley, both experienced astronauts and former Navy test pilots, performed safety checks on the SpaceX capsule before boarding the space station, where they will stay for 1 to 4 months. This is according to National Geographic and NASA. Number six, Target, other retailers close stores as unrest continues. Target Corp. announced Sunday that it was temporarily shutting or limiting hours at 200 stores as protests continued over the police killing of George Floyd in Minneapolis. Retail outlets in several cities have been looted, adding to their problems as they struggle to reopen after coronavirus lockdowns. In Los Angeles, for example, numerous upscale stores were broken into, including Alexander McQueen on Rodeo Drive and Nordstrom and Apple in the nearby Grove Shopping Center. Quote, "We hope to reopen our doors as soon as possible," end quote, Nordstrom said in a statement. Quote, "We had impacts at some of them and are in the process of assessing any damage so we can resume serving customers," end quote. Apple said it would keep some of its doors closed on Sunday. This is according to Reuters. Number seven, more religious congregations resume services with social distancing. A rising number of religious congregations resumed in-person worship services over the weekend, many with social distancing rules to reduce the spread of the novel coronavirus. The Archdiocese of Philadelphia, for example, resumed public mass but restricted churches to half occupancy, filling only every other pew. The Church of Jesus Christ of Latter-day Saints resumed some services in Alaska, Georgia, Louisiana, Illinois, and Utah, but continued closures in Nevada, Hawaii, Washington, and other states. Some states have included religious organizations in blanket bans against large gatherings. More than half the states have continued to permit religious gatherings despite the pandemic, but many churches, synagogues, and mosques across the country have live stream services as a safety measure. This is according to the New York Times. Number eight, Biden visits scene of Delaware protests. Former Vice President Joe Biden on Sunday visited the site of protest in Wilmington, Delaware, against police brutality and against African Americans. Biden, the presumptive Democratic presidential nominee, wore a mask as he met with people at the scene of the demonstrations in an outing that marked his second public appearance since the start of coronavirus lockdowns in mid-March. Quote, "The only way to bear this pain is to turn all that anguish to purpose," end quote, Biden wrote on Instagram. Quote, "And as president, I will help lead this conversation. And more importantly, I will listen," end quote. The protests have been ongoing across the United States since last Monday, when George Floyd, a 46-year-old unarmed black man, died after a white Minneapolis police officer pressed his knee into Floyd's neck for several minutes. This is according to CNN. Number nine, Minnesota Attorney General to assist prosecutor with George Floyd cases. Minnesota Attorney General Keith Ellison on Sunday announced he will assist Hennepin County Attorney Mike Freeman in cases stemming from the death of George Floyd. Freeman said there have been, quote, "recent developments in the facts of the case where the help and expertise of the attorney general would be valuable," end quote. And Ellison has agreed to be a full partner. Floyd died last Monday after a Minneapolis police officer pressed his knee into Floyd's neck for several minutes as Floyd told him, quote, "I can't breathe," end quote. The officer, Derek Chauvin, was fired on Tuesday, along with three others who were at the scene. Chauvin was arrested and charged on Friday with third-degree murder and second-degree manslaughter. On Saturday, Floyd's family asked that Ellison take over the case. This is according to CBS Minnesota. Number 10, Christo, artist who framed landmarks in fabric, dies at 84. The artist Christo, known for public artworks featuring fabric-wrapped buildings and natural landmarks, died Sunday of natural causes. He was 84. Christo and his late wife, Jean-Claude, were credited with changing the way people thought about iconic sites and about art. Some of their best-known projects included Pont Neuf Bridge in Paris, a string of islands in Miami's Biscayne Bay, and the Reichstag in Berlin. At the time of his death, Christo was preparing for one of his most ambitious works yet, wrapping the Arc de Triomphe in Paris, scheduled for September 2021. Quote, Christo and Jean-Claude's artwork brought people together in shared experiences across the globe, end quote, his office said in a statement. Quote, and their work lives on in our hearts and memories, end quote. This is according to Art News. That's 10 things you need to know today for Monday, June 1st, 2020. Thank you so much for listening. I hope that you're doing reasonably well in your neck of the woods. I hope everybody stays safe out there. I usually don't editorialize these things, but this news lately has been getting very, very disheartening. Peace. Peace, everybody. That's what I hope for you, and safety, of course. This has been What Makes You Smarter. If you'd like to tell your story or hear the stories of others, I encourage you to check out my other podcast, What Makes You Famous. Find it everywhere using the hashtag What Makes You Famous. That's it for me. It's Keys Dan, RadioWhat.com, DJLittleRock.com. Peace. I'm out of here. Peace. I'm out of here. Peace. If you like what you hear, I encourage you to follow What Makes You Smarter on social media. Find it on Facebook at What Makes You Smarter, Instagram at What Makes You Smarter, Twitter at Smarter What, and YouTube, username Keys Dan. Leave What Makes You Smarter podcast a review and subscribe. Listen to What Makes You Smarter podcast on Spotify, iTunes, YouTube, Stitcher, Google Podcasts, and Podcast Addict, my personal favorite. Learn with me on my podcast, What Makes You Smarter. And if you'd like to tell your story, I encourage you to check out my other podcast, What Makes You Famous. Find it everywhere using the hashtag What Makes You Famous. Call 501-470-6386 and leave a message to set up a time for What Makes You Famous. Support What Makes You Smarter podcast using the PayPal, paypal.me/KeysDan. Email info@RadioWhat.com. What Makes You Smarter is a production of Keys Dan Enterprises Incorporated at KeysDan.com. Thank you for listening.